National Academies of Sciences recently published a new biology paradigm, and they said that the current division between different subjects of biology was a mistake, that biology should be only one master subject. And then they went on to say that in their vision of a new biology paradigm, microbiology was destined to play a key role. And this is because precisely we only know 1% of the microbes. And the more we discover in these microbes, we discover new uses for them, new things they do, basic research in science, in medicine, in food security, cosmetics. One industry after another is heavily dependent on access to microbial specimens and plant cultivar. The Convention on Biological Diversity created a regime of misappropriation, international misappropriation, meaning if you take genetic resources from a developing country without permission, the Nagoya Protocol says this is a violation of international law. So what it means is I will be able to go directly into the courts of your country and sue, file a complaint, and then I will be able to seize your illegal product at the border. So the Nagoya Protocol will have a big effect on the enforcement of rights in genetic resources and traditional knowledge. Indigenous peoples have played a big role in the discovery of microbes in their everyday life. When indigenous people suffer from illnesses from microbes, what have they done to combat those illnesses? Have they used plants? Have they used some food? These are clues to potential sources of medicine. They're not only living laboratories, they're also living libraries, because they have historical recollections that go back hundreds and thousands of years. What we want is to promote the sharing of knowledge and the sharing of resources for scientific and industrial development, but at the same time, ensuring that people who make different kinds of contributions share in the rewards.